Hi everyone, it's Lana from Sage and Sound, and this video is about how to cope with Christmas stress. So I've been talking to a lot of my clients recently about how they're going to cope with Christmas Day. There's a few different reasons for people's stress. A lot of it's interpersonal stuff, but they all come to me with the same basic idea, that they're hoping for one outcome but secretly fearing another one. And what this does in our brain is it sets up a place of indecision. Our brain actually acts like there's a decision to be made, which is Christmas going to turn out to be stressful or is it going to be joyful? And because it can't decide between the two, it does what we do whenever we make a decision. We think about one outcome and then we think about the opposite outcome. And if you've been a client of mine for a while, you'll know what this does. Although it's not as strong as actually living through the experience, playing it out in your mind does create some of the stress of living through that experience. So while you're imagining your hopeful experience that Christmas is going to be joyful, it's not too much of a problem. You might even get some positive feelings out of it. But once you swap down into what you fear will happen, the negative outcome, you're going to be producing the stress response. And as we well know, we don't think about decisions once, we think about them many, many times and all the different little iterations of how things could go wrong. Sometimes how they can go right, but we do tend to focus on how they go wrong. And all that is just increasing your stress response. So how do you get past that? The solution's a bit counterintuitive. What you need to do is actually expect that what you fear is going to happen will come true, which sounds super negative, but it's actually not. The reason we do that is that if you're fearing it, it's probably likely it's happened in the past, and we don't want to act on the expectation that people are going to change. If they do change, that's awesome. You'll have a great Christmas. You don't need to worry about it. What we need to worry about is how you're going to cope if they're not going to change. So by saying they're probably not, we get to pull ourselves out of that indecision space. Now we've only got one outcome to think about, and that's how we'll cope when people behave as they've always behaved. And there's a really awesome catchphrase you can use in these situations called, "Of course they did." So instead of being surprised when, you know, your dad gets drunk like he does every year, you can just say to yourself, "Of course he did. That's what he does." And it just takes a lot of the stress out of it. And there's no more surprise because we weren't hoping he was going to do anything differently. Just repeat to yourself, "Of course they did. Of course they did." It doesn't mean that it's a fun experience, but it takes the stress out of it. So if you want to up level it into a bit of a fun experience though, you can then tack on another technique called the Spotto technique. Spotto comes from a car game that you play with kids. So if you're on a long trip, you can print out these boards and they have little icons on them. Things like, you know, seeing a plane, going over a bridge, and you play it like bingo. When you see one of those things out the car window, you cross it off and you're trying to get Spotto in a line, or Spotto the whole board if you're on a really long car trip. So you can play this game by yourself, or if you have a really sympathetic partner or sibling, you might be able to play it with them as well. And what you do is you basically figure out all the things that are likely to happen. So if we're sticking with the dad getting too drunk example, it might be, you know, dad insists on doing cheers at every single course. Dad insists we play Scrabble as drinking Scrabble. Dad trips over his own feet, dad slurs his words, mum rolls her eyes, sister bursts into tears and tells him to go to AA, whatever it is, if you think it's likely to happen, you just create a little Spotto for it, and then by yourself or with your partner or your sibling on the day, when those things happen, again, you're not gonna get upset by it. You knew it was gonna happen, and you can just be like, "Oh, Spotto, we just did cheers for the third time. Spotto, he rolled his ankle under the mat or something," whatever it's going to be. And doing this actually just takes a lot of the stress out of it for you. It turns it into something that might almost be funny, but even if it's not quite funny, you'll be a lot more detached when you're not attached to the outcome. So as long as we hope for something to be a particular way, we're really emotionally attached to the outcome. And when we drop that hope and we're just expecting it to be like it's been before, it just frees up some emotional energy. We don't have it all tied up in hopes and expectations, and we can use that energy to enjoy ourselves, and we won't be so attached to the negative experience. We can just be like, oh yeah, knew that was coming, and then you turn your attention to something else that you enjoy more. So they are my top tips for coping with any stress at Christmas. If it feels relevant to you and you give them a go, I'd love to know how it works. Does it take some of the stress out of Christmas for you? And are you able to get a bit of emotional distance from some of those things that do cause us a lot of stress at Christmas? So I hope you have a happy Christmas and a great new year, and I'll talk to you in 2020. See ya.